So what today what we are going to see is that what is faster RCNN algorithm or network, how it actually works. So for that we just have to at least summarize that what this RCNN was doing. So RCNN used to take these region proposals and over that it do some sort of warping so as to get the same size so that you can show it to your CNNs. This CNN can be VGG network or any network that you feel that it can be a shared network. And then over that you apply SVM and bounding box regression. So this is the recipe that they have shown, that you download any AlexNet model and AlexNet, VGG, whatever. You remove the last layer, add your layer, retrain, and your classifier head is actually being trained. And you cache, once it's trained, you cache all those things, the pool 5 features or whatever the layer from which you wanted to extract your features, and save them on your hard disk. You can save that. And then for every class, you train one SVM, support vector machine. So positive class and negative class. So you have one versus rest classifier for each and every class, which essentially mean using that you can do multi-class classification. And so this will be saying that this is a cat, this is a cat, and this is not a cat, and accordingly you will get your network trained, SVM trained. Here it is saying that for the bounding box regression, that is a linear regression that they have used, that regression says that whatever the bounding box that's been given to me by my region proposal, it may not be perfectly correct. So what difference or what shift one should have to do? So delta x, delta y, and delta height and delta w are the things that you want to know, so that given x, y, height and width, how one can shift and switch so as to get the better possible proposals. Is this okay to everyone? These are the two heads that are going to be used. One, which is going to do the classification for you. Second, which is doing the bounding box regression. Bounding box regression is the thing which is being applied over the given region proposal, because region proposals may not be perfectly correct. So given a region proposal, you wanted to extend its, you know, the dimensions, x, y, height and width, maybe extend or maybe shrink, depends upon that where it is. And accordingly, if you do that, then probably you are going to get a proper proper bounding box. So this is the thing that's been done. So we have seen. So why I have reiterated, because the same thing one should have to again understand for faster RCNN. So this fast, so the reason you all understand that what was the reasons behind the, you know, training such a network, and we have seen that instead of applying it over the patches one by one, you want to apply it over the whole image directly, and you know that by ROI pooling, you can extract the corresponding region proposal, extract the region proposals features, VGG features, from this high resolution feature map that you have got. And over that again, FC layer is working. Yes. So this is the original image. Over that I apply this convolution. Over this I have applied this convolution. Now I know that there is a region over here in my image. This is a patch. So I can similarly find out this thing. Yes, because I know that how much amount of max pooling and so on. So once you have got this, so you have got in one go, in one forward pass, you have got all the features for each and every region proposal.
So first you find regions in the main image, then you find the corresponding areas in the...
Of course, yeah. So ROI has this selective search or any region proposal algorithm is giving me regions over here. I wanted to find out the corresponding features, so I take them and feed it to my network one by one. This was the problem. He says that instead of that, apply big convolution network over the whole image directly and get that information. So that is why it becomes very, very fast for testing as well.
Sir,
yes.
In the time of training, we need to provide x and y and w and h for each of the regions.
for each of the
region.
See, yeah, so that is the ground truth of any of the detection network. That given an image, what is the ground truth? Given an image. I have few objects that you know. This is my object number 1, object number 2, object number 3, object number 4, object number 5, I don't know. All of them are there. There is a cat, there is a dog, there is a man, there is a car. And for each and everything, you will write that this, it's a car, and x, y, height, width, this, it is something, object 2, x, y, height and width, x, y, height and width, x, y, height and width, x, y, height and width. So, in this way, you will be having a full ground truth 5 for one image itself. And if you wanted to print any of the detection network, you have to provide this.
But sir, when we apply convolution net and we get this convolution 5 feature map, then these will be different?
Yeah, so these will be different. So, you want that if you are saying that there is a cat and ground truth says that there is indeed a cat, then the probability should have to be high first of all for that region. But that region proposal may not be exactly correct. So you want, because your region proposal may have said that there is something which is like suppose that this, right? It may not be perfectly overlapping with that. So you want that, okay, there is a cat. So first thing your classifier should have to tell that there is a cat, because there's the object, that is the actual object, that is the ground truth for this. And the second thing that it has to say that I have to move it slightly left, so as to get the better or get it closer to the ground. These are the two things one should have to get our network learning. So once it is done, so similarly, so the only thing which is being left here was that your FCs are actually being trained for that small size feature, and you are right now getting a big size feature. So how one can train? So what we have done is that we take this convolutional layer and apply it over, see, you know, this is a high resolution, and over that you do the feature level pooling. That's the region of interest pooling. So ROI pooling. Remember that if you wanted to reshape your features, you will have to do ROI pooling. And in this way it works and things are fine. And they have shown that their performance actually got better. And finally they have actually come up with another network that is being called as the faster RCNN. Yes. So this faster RCNN actually, so now what's the problem with your network? Now the only problem is that they have shown that their performance is good and they have got results very fast. But still the main bottleneck was that region proposals are being happening outside of your network. And if suppose that your region proposals are actually outside of your network, it's not being first of all parallelized, things are outside of your network, it's not fully batch propagable. And because of that, it actually performance is also, you know, not saturating as well as the time is going to take, it's actually taking good amount of time. So now they want to come up with a network that's being called as the region proposal network, RPN. And this was the main advantage, first of all, this was the main, you can say the highlight of this paper. Both of these previous FAST and RCNN, you cannot train, they are very bulky to train. You have to cache features, this and that, and even if you do not want to cache, if you have the FAST, then RPN, this region proposals have to be done offline. You will not be able to do that, but faster RCNN, you can train faster RCNN, because complete single network it is, and easily you just have to provide the ground truth the way in which it actually wants, the way I just have explained, and then it will work. Now the point is that what now the only thing which is coming in between is that over full image I apply CNN. Once I got these features, over that I will apply my region proposal network. And this region proposal network is being trained separately. And this network's responsibility is to, given this feature map, can you give me the corresponding regions? Remember, selective search or any type of region proposal or this region proposal network, it can actually be seen as a class agnostic object detection. It actually says that I do not know that there is an object or not, I do not know that what is this object, but I feel that there is an object. I can tell you that given this image, there can be object here, there can be an object here, there can be an object here. So if I make a bounding box, I feel that these are the regions where I will be having some bounding box. So region proposal network and remaining other things are exactly same. Once you have got these region proposals, over that, what you are going to do? You are again going to apply the... So basically, you have got the convolutional features directly. So over that, you just have to take them, apply ROI pooling, and just give it to your FCS. Is this okay? You understand how it's going to work further? It's directly going to be working like... Because here you have got the full features, over these features you have got the proposals, these proposals feature map you directly have got, the application map, the features, and you just give it to your fully connected network directly. So you can give it to, so you do, I mean first you do the ROI pooling and then give it to your classifier FC layers and the bounding box regression. Yes. See, the point is that from feature map you have, this is actually the proposal. This is just x1, y1, x2, y2. Features are here. Yeah, features are here. So using these features and using these proposals, you warp it to get the final thing that you want to show it to your classifier. So once it is done, thing which is now being left is actually how this region proposal actually works. So that is actually the main heart and the different thing that they have done. And so far, I think that is actually a very good. In fact, it's actually complicated as well. So let us see it slowly, one by one, that whatever the possible understanding that we can have. And then you will have to. There are multiple resources from which you can also see. So let us start. This region proposal network. So this region proposal network, let's go one by one. That suppose that if I have a image and the image assumes that the size is say 600 by 1000, and over this if I have a object like this, I have some object like this. Is this okay? Given 600 by 1000, so what happened is that whatever the size of image that you have, this network will first convert into 600, and the corresponding aspect ratio, maintaining that aspect ratio, what is the corresponding? So, faster RCNN essentially works on any size image. Just it fixes the 600 this thing, and then accordingly it will scale. So now suppose that if you have, this is your ground truth, and assume that. So let us go one by one. So over that I apply my VGG network. And go to and apply 4 max pooling. So I have applied 4 max pooling. So if I say that what I am going to get is that VGG is actually converting it into 60 by 40 because it is actually 4 max pooling. So this will actually be 600 by 16. And this will be something like 1000 by 16. And how many such things? So VGG says that, it's like 512. So if you see your VGG network, it may not be that exactly 60 and 40 is going to be the size, because the input size of BGG is something else. Remember, BGG is a CNN, convolutional network. You take those filter and apply it over an image. I am saying that I am applying it over 600 and 1000. So if you apply, then the size is going to be different. So here you are going to get 60 by 40, and essentially it is by 16, because there are 4 max pooling. Is this okay to everyone? 4 max pooling. Now, now if I talk about 1 pixel over here, I'm talking about this 1 pixel over here, and say that this is my x, y in this feature map. The corresponding, assume that the corresponding xy is here, capital X, comma, capital Y in the whole image. Then if I say that I wanted to have a neighborhood over here, say 3x3 neighborhood, assume that there is some corresponding neighborhood over here. Now this is one anchor box that I'm talking with respect to this XY in my original image. Slowly you go with me, because it's slightly complicated and nowhere it's properly written. So we somehow have to come to a consensus that what is actually happening. You understand that I have got an image, over that I have got some ground truth. I apply a network over that. I have got some features that are coming out of my network. If I take a single pixel in my feature map, it corresponds to an image pixel, and the corresponding feet, 3x3 or 5x5, if I see over here on the feature map, it can actually be seen there in the original image itself. Now, you just think about that. If I wanted to say anything about this anchor box, I want to say something about this anchor box. What one should have to say is that for this anchor box, if I say that it is x comma y, then what is the probability that x comma y is having an object? Your region proposal network or any region proposal algorithm only says that what is the probability by which I am saying that this contains an object or not. What object? You do it using your classifier later. It only says, so whether it is having an object or not is actually going to become if there exist any ground truth bounding box with IOU more than 0.7. You take any pixel, you take this anchor box, and you, using this anchor box, you check that with respect to this, all of my ground truth, is there any object which is having an IOU more than 0.5, then you will say that, yeah, this is this object, I feel that can be a bounding box or a region proposal. It's a candidate for a region proposal. Fine. This is one thing. And what is IOU? IOU. Let me explain. IOU is intersection over union, which essentially means that if you have this as one proposal, or this is one bounding box, you have another bounding box, then the IOU is intersection over the union. So intersection over union is going to be equal to 1 if there is a complete overlap, otherwise it may not be. So this is actually a way by which we are saying that there is an overlap. How much amount of overlap? 0.7, which means that yes, it is very close. That's fine. So, yes.
So when you say probability that x, y has an object, you're saying the reasons surrounding x, y.
Yeah.
I'm going to talk about that.
But right now I am saying that only one boundary, only one bounding box and aspect ratio and scale. I am saying that just fix whatever it's over here. You translate it over here and say that, what is this? And you check. So now the point is that for each and every point over here, yes, you can do this and you can find out actually the what is the correct, with respect to ground truth and with respect to one anchor box, what can be the probability and what is the corresponding bounding box. Because this itself is the bounding box, but what is the corresponding bounding box? The corresponding bounding box, suppose that if this bounding box is having object score 1, it must be with respect to some ground truth, because of which it is saying that I am more than 0.7. So that corresponding ground truth box x, y, height and width have to be the corresponding bounding box proposals with respect to this point. It has to be. Do you understand? That suppose that you have got a bounding box over here. This is my another anchor box. So this is my another anchor box. Now for this anchor box, you are saying that it is having an IOU with this one, the second ground truth box. So what is the probability for this XY? For this XY, the objectness is going to be, object probability that for XY and this object score is going to be equal to 1. And what is the corresponding XY height and width? It has to be for this ground truth box. I think it's clear. So if you understand this, what we are going to do is that,
how did you come up with the ground truth box?
You know that what is the ground truth box. You have to annotate. I have said that what is the ground truth for your network to be trained. So for every image you will have to tell that this is my ground truth, this is my ground truth, this is my ground truth.
Manually,
that's the first line I have said, you have asked. That given an image, you will have to say that there is a cat, there is a dog, there is this. And the corresponding class level along with the XY height and width. Class level, XY height and width. Class level, height and width. So for every image you require, for each and every object, for each and every image, you will have to write this. This is the ground truth. Once you know that ground truth, for each and every feature pixel, you can back project and find out that what is the corresponding this value. So what are the things that you wanted to know? First thing that your classifier have to understand. What? That given this XY, what is the corresponding probability by which I can say that it can be a region proposal? And the second thing is that if it is a region proposal, then what is the correct bounding box location? Because it may not be perfectly correct. It is having an IOU of 0.7 or more with respect to a particular ground truth object box. So you will have to say that for this, it has to be this thing.
Then we are going to check that bounding box with that IOU with each of the ground truth bounding box.
Each of the ground truth bounding box,
for each pixel we are mapping that bounding box there.
Yes.
And for that bounding box we are going to match the original ground truth with from each of the ground truth.
Yeah, for each of the ground truth. And for whichever you are getting the high value.
Yes.
So you just use first one, which is the maximum. Because here you are not, there may be a cat, there may be a dog. Cat is a higher probability, the other one is lesser. You do not worry about that. You just wanted to say that there is this, because this is not your worry. Your worry is that I feel that there is an object. Cat is also saying 0.8 and dog is also saying 0.7. You take the cat ones, bounding box. So value will be 0.8 and the corresponding x, y, height and width is going to be coming from the cat itself.
Yes, so
with this, let us see now what's been actually done. So you understand that this is the ground truth that you have. You want your network to see this ground truth and have to give this thing back. Because whatever is the ground truth, that is the thing you wanted your network to be trained for. So let us see that what you wanted to do now is I'm telling you that how we are going to fix this scale and aspect ratio things. Fine. So, if I say that aspect ratio is one thing, and I wanted to say that 1 is to 1, 1 is to 2, and 2 is to 1, which essentially mean that either this, or this, or this, and then I will say that scale is equal to 128, 256, and 512, which essentially mean that for 28 by, this is 128 by 128 for first scale, for second scale it will be 256 by 256, and for third scale it will be 512 by 512, and so on. So how many? You have got 9 anchor boxes. So for each and every XY, as I have said that I am interested to somehow get one thing over here, I am saying that not one, I want 9. I want to say that I assume that with respect to this pixel, with respect to this pixel, this XY, can you tell me that there is an object? Then as soon as I say that there is an object, you will say that at what scale and at what aspect ratio? And then I will say aspect ratio first and scale first, which essentially means that 128 by 128 is the bounding box. Anchor box, I'm sorry. That's the anchor box. Then you will say that what for the next sizes, 1 is to 1, but second scale. 1 is to 1, third scale. 1 is to 2. And so on. So which essentially mean that at here I will be looking for this, 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 and so on for all these 9 things. Yes.
So finally we take maximum.
Yeah, so that is non-maximum, the pressure is being applied at last. But how to, so this is actually the ground truth generation. And now given this ground truth, how you can train your network is, now remember what we have got up to this. We have got 60 by 40 by 200 and, sorry, it was, yeah, so it was 512. Yes, 512. Maybe, and then, I wanted to apply, first I am going over this, I am going to apply a filter. What is that filter? This filter is actually 3 by 3 by 512. So if I apply a 3 by 3 by 512, which essentially mean the same thing. This is 3 by 3 and 512, I have applied one such filter. And you can understand that if I apply one such filter over here, it is going to be seeing all this stuff. So it's actually seeing a 3 by 3 patch, which is corresponding to the, you know, corresponding things over here in your image. And you have got a feature. What is going to be the size now if you apply one such filter, 60 by 40? That's the same. So 60 by 40. You will get a 60 by 40. And how many such? So I am saying that if I apply D2 such filters. If I apply D2 such filters, you will get D2 such maps. So these D2 such maps, which essentially mean that you have got 60 by 40 by D2, and Again, if I say that I am talking about same XY, where is that corresponding 3 by 3 information? It is here, it is here, it is here, and it is here. This one, how you have got 3 by 3 by 512 first filter, then 3 by 3 by 512 second filter, and so on. So all of them, if you take all these D2 values, that is going to talk something about them here, and they are actually talking something about the image. So here, this thing is actually talking about this, which is going to talk about this. Now what I'm going to do is that we will be applying a 1 by 1 by D2 filter. Now there's a simple thing. 1 by 1 by D2 filter is going to give me 60 by 40. Assume that it is k equal to 1. Then I apply another for k equal to 2. I'm applying 45 such filters. Why is 45? Very soon you will understand. I will apply k equal to 9 such filters. And then k equal to 10, 11. I am saying that this is my map number 1, activation map 2, activation map 9, activation map 10, activation map 11, activation map 12, activation map 13, and so on. And finally, I will be having activation map 45, 44, 43, and 42. Now, what does this mean? Let's go one by one. That if I talk about the same pixel over here, x, y, which is here, which is essentially all of them, actually the representation which is actually coming from the upper part. If I take this single xy, what it has to say? This is actually my first aspect ratio and the class probabilities. That what is the probability that I have said? What I have said is that you take one pixel in the feature map, take a neighborhood, see it in the image, and then you will have to tell that with respect to what scale and what aspect ratio this XY is an object. I am saying that 9 such things. What are those 9 such things? First, second, and 9. These are the all 9 anchor boxes that you want your network to predict. That what is the probability? Now you have said that I think that at this XY there is a cap. Fine. But at this anchor box, and in this anchor box I feel that there is a cap. Oh, as soon as you say that it is the case, then this is the probability by which I am saying that at this XY there is a cat and at this XY there is a car. But where it is? The corresponding X, Y, height and width are this. You can say that this is X, Y, height. This is bounding box regression thing. You remember that I have said that given any X, Y at a particular scale and an aspect ratio, there can be an object. So you assume that there was an object cat and it was here in the second one. Fine. Then you will say that if it is the case, then where is that cat, actual ground truth of the cat? It has to be given by your network and it is going to be coming over here. So for each and every bounding box, each and every pixel here in the feature map, you are going to say 9 things. nine things in which three different scale and three aspect ratio, what is the corresponding object probability? And if this is the object probability, then what is the corresponding x, y, height and width? Your network has to say, and you know that what is the corresponding ground truth, because you have made that ground truth. You want your network to predict this. Your network is taking, your network is taking this image. And then what it is doing, given this image, I have found out a feature over here. With respect to this feature point, I want to say that I expect that there is some object. Then you say that where it is. I'm saying, see, I am looking for three scales and three aspect ratios. I will take this, place it over here. First one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh one, eighth one. And for all of these eight, I try to look the corresponding ground truth. Is there any ground truth? Bounding box, it says that it is having an object. Where it will be saying, when the IOU is more than 0.7. You have got out of this 9, only one is saying that there is an object. Which one? Say the third one. So the third, corresponding the third object, anchor box, probability value should have to be equal to 1. And for whichever object, it has said, for whichever ground truth this has been said that it's an object, you have to take that corresponding bounding box. Ground truth bounding box. That is the thing. So now, if this is the ground truth, how your network has to predict? Your network has to predict the same thing. Then it will say that I apply, first of all, 3 by 3 by 512. In this way, I am looking a particular patch and I want to see. Then you have got things like this. Over that I apply 1 by 1 by 1 filter, 1 by 1 by. Then I apply this 1 by 1 by D2 filter that is going to give me one sustain. Now this has to somehow tell me about the first anchor box. And for all the pixels, first anchor box, what is that first scale and first aspect ratio? First scale, first aspect ratio, for all the pixels, probability scores for the classifier. Second aspect ratio and first scale for all the pixels. Second one. For all the pixels, this is for the classification thing. And the corresponding classification, if you are saying that there is an object, where it is, go and check these four things. This is also for all x, for all x, y's. But what is this? The corresponding x value, the corresponding y value, the corresponding height value, the corresponding width. So your network, if there is a gap and you assume that it is here, then it has to say that the corresponding height, width and x, y should have to be equal here. The same x value. The same x, y, which means that if m equal to 1, if I write it like probability x comma y comma object, then suppose m1 is saying x comma y comma m1 xy is equal to 1, which means that this is a positive block and the corresponding height, width, where are they? M10 x comma y, M11 x comma y, M12 x comma y, and M13 x comma y.
You know the scale and the aspect ratio of each of the m. So if we have x comma y, we can ourselves find out the height, width, x and y.
Yes, the point is that the proposal that you, that this anchor box, this, you know that this, they are not the anchor box. Anchor box is used to give you the predictions and these anchor box may not be correct. So you wanted that, yes, according to me, this anchor box is saying that there is an object. But the corresponding thing,
is slightly different from that. So this is actually for the bounding box regression. First thing that network can predict anything. It will predict these four values. How they are correct or not, so you will have to train it. So for that I have said that this is the way we have trained our ground truth. We have given our ground truth like take this.
Okay.
Let me
these just
are
the delta things which are going to change a bit.
So this is like delta, yeah, the bounding box regression. Just me rephrase this thing, and this is the thing that you will easily understand now, that given this image, I have found out my feature. I have chosen one thing over here. Over that, I wanted to apply 3 by 3. With this 3 by 3, I will go and apply 1 by 1 by D2 filters and to get the corresponding information, because I have so many things like this in my network. So over that, I apply. But with respect to this, I have got corresponding XY here, then I will take say 1, 2 and 3. Is this okay? Correct. This is my 3 anchor boxes and the corresponding 3 more for the next scale, 3 more for the final scale. So you have got 9 such things. Fine. Now what you do is that, you know that accordingly, I have got a ground truth as well. This is my some ground truth box. Or if I suppose that this is my ground truth box. So you will say that if I take this one and take it to my ground truth, only IOU is less than 0.7. Similarly, for this my IOU is less than 0.7, my IOU is less than, for all of them the IOU is less than 0.7. But if I take another bounding box, say same point, same aspect ratio, but another scale, you have got something. What is that? So your ground truth says that this is a cat with probability equal to, there is a cat. So you have checked that what is the corresponding IOU. IOU coming out to be 0.8 or 0.9. So for this XY and for this scale and for this aspect ratio, you are saying what? You are saying that my ground truth says that the probability has to be equal to 1 because it's a cat, and the corresponding XY should have to be this, this, this and this. This is not the anchor box. Anchor box was so for this anchor box, you have figured out that what is the probability, IOU, and that is for the classification head. But what is for the regression head? Regression head is saying that is the anchor box, that is my answer. No, anchor box has to be properly regressed with respect to your ground. So even you are saying that I assume that this is the anchor box, you take this and bounding box regression, please do the regression for me and make this box stretch or stitch in such a way so that I will get the more and more IOU. So that is why this bounding box will say that these four things are going to be not correct, it has to be the correct thing. These 1, 2, 3, 4 is not the correct one. 1, 2, 3, 4 is the correct one. So that is the ground truth. Your network will say something else initially, but what it has to say is that for this anchor box, you will have to tell that this is the correct thing. So wherever you go, I will subtract, find out the difference, and then propagate. This is the way how RK network is trained. Next lecture, we will talk about the RTL loss, and then it is done. Thank you. One thing I can tell you about this topic is that it's actually in gaseous form. It will evaporate in say 10 minutes. 10 मिनट में उड़ जाएगा आपके दिमाग से अगर आपने इसको अभी थोड़ी देर में या आज ही के दिन में ठीक से नहीं देखा कि गया आपके हाथ से. इट्स नो वे रिटन प्रॉपरली ऑल्सो.